Today we are going to discuss about brain tumors, how they are diagnosed, and the various treatment options available both internationally as well as at our center. Now, even though brain tumors have an incidence of 50 per 1 lakh people, which is relatively rare, but still it is a very major health issue and has a great impact on both the duration and quality of life. Now, to begin with, the term brain tumor by itself is a very general term, and it's like saying a road traffic accident. Just like an accident can cause different kinds of injuries to the brain, similarly, there are different types of brain tumors, each having their own distinct features. Let me talk about the different kinds of brain tumors first. The most common type of brain tumor, surprisingly, does not arise within the nervous system. These are tumors which arise outside in other organs and are then transported to the nervous system through the bloodstream or via lymphatics. Such tumors account for more than 50% of tumors which occur within the brain. These are known as metastases. They most commonly arise from the lungs, breast, or from the gastrointestinal system. Now, small metastases, especially those which are multiple in number, can be managed via radiation, a focused form of radiation called gamma knife radiosurgery, which is done by neurosurgeons. Larger metastases, which cause pressure on the brain and require surgery, metastasis usually has a poor outcome and requires further treatment after neurosurgery for the primary cancer. Coming to the other type of cancers, these are called primary brain tumors and arise from the brain tissue itself, from the cells of the brain. Such primary brain tumors can be cancerous, which are also known as malignant, or non-cancerous. The most common cancerous tumors are gliomas, which arise from supporting cells within the brain. Now, gliomas can be of two types. They can be high-grade or low-grade in nature. High-grade gliomas typically occur in adults. They are very rapidly progressive, and the symptoms progress over few days or weeks. This is typically seen in adults and causes pressure on the brain, resulting in decreased consciousness, weakness, or fits. Now, treatment of these tumors generally involves surgical removal, complete surgical removal as far as possible, followed by multiple cycles of radiotherapy and chemotherapy, which is managed by an oncologist. With these modes of treatment, survival now for high-grade gliomas has been increased to 15 months on an average and 5 to 6 years for grade 3 tumors. On the other hand, low-grade gliomas are much less aggressive than high-grade gliomas and usually present with seizures. Since these tumors carry a risk for changing into high-grade tumors, early surgery is advised, and tackling these tumors at an early stage can prevent the formation of higher-grade tumor. So, gliomas constitute the other 25% of brain tumors. So 75% of all brain tumors are either metastasis or gliomas. Other tumors which happen in lower frequency in adults include ependymomas, pineoblastomas, lymphomas, choroid plexus tumors in children, medulloblastomas in children, and other embryonal tumors in children. Now, coming to non-cancerous tumors, which forms the remaining 25% of brain tumors, the most common types include meningioma, which many people must have heard of. This is usually seen in adult females and can occur in various parts of the brain. They are usually benign, can be tackled just by surgery, and do not require chemotherapy or radiotherapy after surgical management. Surgical excision usually offers good outcome. The other kind of tumors are vestibular schwannomas, a tumor which involves the nerve supplying your ear. Such tumors generally present with hearing loss, and they are benign and slow growing, but still they are very challenging to treat because they occur in the back of your head, and it is a very critical area. So the removal of these tumors can result in a lot of complications, and microneurosurgery is required to deal with such tumors. Another common set of tumors are pituitary tumors, which arise from the pituitary gland, which is a small structure but very important structure at the base of your brain. These tumors can be removed through the nose using an endoscope, in case they are small, or in case of large tumors, we open the skull and remove such tumors. Other tumors which occur rarely include craniopharyngioma, which happens in children, hemangioblastoma, skull-based tumors such as chordomas and chondroblastomas. In addition, tumors involving the orbit, skull, nasal cavity can also erode the surrounding bone and enter inside the brain. This was just a theoretical overview of what most brain tumors look like. However, now more importantly, I would like to tell the people how they should manage when they are confronted with a relative or a friend who has a diagnosis of a brain tumor. First of all, do not ignore symptoms. Symptoms such as long-standing headache and seizures, and especially headache which is associated with vomiting, with increased headache early in the morning and blurring of vision, should not be ignored. Get an MRI done as fast as possible. Secondly, if after doing MRI a brain tumor is diagnosed, consult a neurosurgeon. Medications cannot treat brain tumors. Please be very sure of that. You have to consult a neurosurgeon if there is a brain tumor on the MRI. Thirdly, the neurosurgeon, after seeing your MRI and whatever other scans are required, they decide what kind of tumor it is, what surgery is required, and what kind of surgery is required, whether the tumor needs to be removed completely, or a partial removal is enough, or a biopsy can be done, or we can also treat the tumor using an endoscope or through minimal access surgery. Fourthly, please understand that many brain tumors are life-threatening conditions, and the result of brain tumor surgery depends not just on the type of tumor, but also on the location and the size of the tumor. For example, a meningioma is a very common tumor which occurs in adult females. However, all meningiomas are not the same. A meningioma which happens on the top of your brain is very different from a meningioma which happens on the base of your brain or at the back of your brain. Tumors which are located at the base of the brain or at the back of the brain are much more complicated, they involve more critical areas of the brain, and therefore the chances of complication in such tumors is much higher. Therefore, in addition to the type of tumor, the location of the tumor and its size is also very important in deciding what the outcome will be. Fifthly, to all the relatives of patients who have been diagnosed with brain tumors, please be ready to give prolonged care. Treatment does not end with surgery. Post-operative oncological consultation, preferably going to an oncology center with chemoradiotherapy, is required in most cases. Therefore, if you are not willing for further treatment with an oncologist, just going for a surgery will not treat the brain tumor. Therefore, I would also like to inform you that at Orchid Medical Center, we have the latest neurosurgical equipment to deal with all kinds of brain tumors. We have a high-end neurosurgical microscope, an ultrasonic aspirator, as well as a drill here, and microsurgical instruments, which allow us to serve you better. Therefore, do not lose hope if you are met with a diagnosis of brain tumor. Get an early consultation with a neurosurgeon and get the best treatment modern day medicine has to offer. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Dear viewers, if you have any query regarding this, please drop it in the comment box. We will address it to Dr. Vikram Singh. Thank you.